We are living through uncertain times. I don't think anybody, including the epidemiologists, know exactly how and when we are going to come out of the current pandemic conditions. And the first priority, of course, is to save lives. At the same time, we also have to understand and respond to the economic fallout, because the impact is quite major. It would not be a complete exaggeration to say that what we are living through is a combination of the 1918 flu pandemic, elements of the Great Depression, and elements of the Great Recession of 2007-2008. The priority has to be to stem the tide to the extent possible so that when the pandemic is over, the economy can start returning back to normal. And in the process, we try to protect the most vulnerable people in society. I think most developed economies have the tools for doing that. Where IFC can be more directly helpful is identifying where the global supply chain is most in trouble and help bolster the supply chain so that the failure of a few critical corporations does not spread throughout the economy. In almost all developing countries, there is a vibrant private sector. Our priority has to be to protect that private sector and protect the employment opportunities and income opportunities of the vast majority of the people. So that does require collaboration between state and society. It requires the state adopting policies in order to bolster the safe social safety net, but also at the same time support the private sector so that you don't create widespread failures. It is absolutely a critical juncture. I think that follows from what I've said so far. If we do not urgently deal with the dire situation we are in, it will cause huge loss of life and turn into a deep depression. And how well we deal with the situation depends on leadership, depends on the existing strength of our institutions, on trust and communication between state and society. And it depends on the actions of civil society, media, and other organizations from bottom up, making demands, coming up with ideas, trying to make up for the lack of resources or lack of leadership from the state. I think the onus is on all of us that we have to try to do the best of these tumultuous times.